Hello everyone. Today topic is pest of banana. Few points about importance of banana. Here banana is a very important fruit crop in tropical world. They are grown largely by smallholders and play a major role in food security and income generation for millions of poor peoples. In terms of gross value of production, banana is the developing world's fourth most important food crop after rice, wheat and maize, and as a fruit it's ranked first in gross value production. Let's see the pest of banana one by one. First one is rhizome weevil Cosmopolitis sordidus Curculianidae Coleoptera. Here symptom is the grub cause death of unopened stem and withering of outer leaf, and also bore into the rhizome and caused the death of plants. Coming to biology, here egg period is 5 to 8 days and 30 to 50 eggs per female. Here egg laid in small burrow made by adult weevil on the plant at ground level. Grubs about 25 days period. It is apodous and yellowish with a reddish head. Here pupal period is about 6 days. Pupation takes place in chamber near the surface of cone and change into pupa within the chamber. And adult, it's a black colored weevil, longevity about a 1 year period. For the management, trap adult weevil with the pseudostem chopped into small pieces in a pot or without pot and place into 15 per hectare, and uproot and destroy the infected rhizomes from the field. They also use the pest-free sucker for planting and apply carbofuron and lindane for the effective management, like prolinage method. Alright, what is the prolinage? Here, use the spot sucker for this method and drain the roots and the decayed portion, and it should be mixed with the clay slurry. Both cones and suckers are dipped in clay slurries with the carbofuron 3G chemical, and we can go for planting of suckers. Next pest is pseudostem borer. Both are weevils. Scientific name is Odoporus longicollis, same Curculionidae Coleoptera. Here the grub makes boreholes and tunnels in the pseudostem and cause wilting of the plants. Biology is egg, grub, pupal, adult. Here egg period is about 3 to 5 days. Here eggs laid in the area of pseudostem about 1 to 1.5 meter above the ground level. Here grub is 27 days, apodous, and pupal period about 24 days, and pupation takes inside the tunnels towards the periperi sideways. Okay, adult, reddish brown and black weevil. For the management, you can go for pruning and remove the dried leaves periodically and keep the field clean, and use the health or pest free suckers to check the pest incident. You can go for monocrotophos, uproot the infested trees, chop into pieces and can burn. Also go for injection, stem injection with the neem azal at 4:4 with the water, and also go for swabbing with the neem azal 4% as a pseudostem injector. They also use the fungus like Beaveria basiana. They also use the entomopathogenic nematode like Heterodora indica. The next one is fruit flies. Here, three striped fruit fly or guava fruit fly, that is Bactrozira diversa, dark brown with the hyaline wings and the yellow legs. And next, oriental fruit fly, mango fruit fly, say Bactrozira dorsalis tapetidae order Diptera. Here, maggots make a puncture on banana fruits by scrabbing, and adult by oviposition. And maggot will cause a damage inside the fruits occasionally. And importance of feeder, that is banana aphids, Pentatomidae nigronervosa, aphididae Hemiptera. Vector of important disease, that is bunchy top of banana, and they are seen in colonies, okay, on leaf axis and pseudostem. Here female can produce 30 to 50 young ones by parthenogenesis type of reproduction. For the management, same, destroy the affected plant pots with the rhizomes and spray methyl dimethyl monocrotophos and inject monocrotophos like 1 ml per plant. That should be 1 ml diluted in 4 ml of water at 45 days interval from third month to flowering. Here, note, we avoid injection of monocrotophos after flowering. Only monocrotophos injection up to flowering from third month. And also encourage the activities of predators like cygnus, chylomeres, ex maculatus, chrysoperla, cornea and other coccinellates and pathogens like Beavria baseana. And next one is lace-winged bug, Stephanitis typicus, Tingidae hemiptera. Here, damage is both nymphs and adult feeding colonies on under surface of leaves and cause discoloration. Here, adults are very small and dull-colored or white bugs with the transparent, shiny, lace-like reticulated wings. And nymphs are black in color. For the management, we can go for methyl dimethyl or dimethyl monocrotophos or quinophos or any other systemic insecticide. And coming to scales, so coconut scales or transparent scale or Bourbon scale, that is Aspidiotus destructor Diaspididae hemiptera. Next species is red wax scale or pink wax scale, that is Ceroplastus rubens Coccidae hemiptera. Next one is fig wax scale, Ceroplastus rossi Coccidae hemiptera. Next one is black line or thread scale or Ischnaspis longirostris Diaspididae hemiptera. Look, note, there is two type of family scale insect like Coccidae and Diaspididae. Coccidae coming under soft scale and Diaspididae coming under hot scale categories. Egyptian cottony cushion scale, breadfruit or mealybug, that is Isaria aegyptiaca Coccidae hemiptera. Oleander scales or oyster scale, false oleander scales hemiptera Diaspididae. Here, symptoms for common symptom for scales is drying and withering of plant pots by severe sap feeding characters of scales. Next one is Protromus clypeatus Myridae family order hemiptera. Here, the adults and nymphs suck the cell sap from the undersurface of the leaves. Next one is fittle bug Phymastotheca deschampsi Cercoptidae hemiptera. Next one is thrips species. First one is fruit rust thrips Catenoporothrips signipennis and flower thrips Thrips florum, leaf thrips Helionothrips catalepilus and Panthototrips indicus Thripidae thysanoptera. Here, both nymphs and adult lacerate the sap from leaves and fruits, which resulting in yellowing of leaves and corky scab formation on fruits, like fruit cracking or splitting, and rusty red coloration patches on fruits. Next type is leaf feeders. First one is Castor hairy caterpillar, Pericalia resini. Arctidae Lepidoptera larvae, black with brown head having long brown hairs. Adults, grey colored with dark spots on the pinkish hind wings. Their management, you can go for collect and destruction of egg mosses and also the caterpillars and use burning torch to kill the congregated larva and use light trap to attract and kill the adult. Also go for Chloriperipos or quinolphos 2 ml per liter. And banana skippers, that is round palm red dye Erionota taurus Hesperidae family Lepidoptera order. Symptom is heavy defoliation and nettle caterpillars blue striped nettle grub, that is Parasa lepida. This also symptom is heavy defoliation. Next, Tobacco caterpillar Spodoptera litura Noctuidae Lepidoptera. Here, young larvae feed by scraping the leaves from ventral surface and later on feeding voraciously at night on foliage, and here larvae, pale greenish or brown with dark marking, adult is yellow and purplish spot in the submarginal area. Their forewings have wavy white markings, hindwings are whitish with brown patches along with golden margins. And for the management, handpicking and destroy the larva, and also use the summer plowing method and use light trap, spray chloropyrifos or release the bacillus thuringiensis, also release the egg parasites such as Telonomus spodopterae and Telonomus ramus. Here I end my presentation. Thank you.